Today's episode is brought to you by Carhartt. They've been outfitting this motherfucker for over 20 years. Good stuff. Holds up really well. It's starting to get cold outside. You know it's not cold enough to bring in the brass monkey because his balls are safe for right now. It's colder than a witch's tip, kind of. You know, that's probably pretty damn cold. Crack your teeth cold, I guess, if you took a bite on it or whatever you do with the witch's tit. I don't know. What else? Cold. Well, it's foggy out here today. Foggy as hell, like pea soup. Pretty damn thick. Cut it with a knife. So, I don't know what that means in October. I know if this was August, it would count how many snowfalls we'd have in the coming winter. So hopefully, this means something too, because I fucking love snow. I got 4 fucking wheel drive. I can get in the snow. I got new tires. So maybe this year, I'll have some fun out in it. Hopefully I don't wreck this son of a bitch, because it's got to hold up for a few more years. Another dilemma that I have is my blend door is broken on my heater and air conditioning. And the actuator doesn't work either. And to take that off, I got to pull the dash out, drop the steering wheel. It's about a 4 or 5 hour job, I think. Now, I've seen YouTube videos where two guys work together and they do it in 45 minutes. But that's like on an American car. This is a truck, which is an American truck, and it's not a new truck. It's like an 02 Ford F-150. Lariat crew cab or super crew. Anyhow, that doesn't matter. What does matter is when it gets to the point where I gotta think it's too cold for me, or in the summertime or springtime for that matter, it gets too hot for me, what I did is I cut a hole in my glove box, fit my hand through a rectangle with a Dremel. Perfect rectangle, kinda. And then I cut another hole in the duct, like the plastic housing around where the blend door is. So I prop it open. What I did is I got a 2x4 and I cut it off by about 3 inches by like 3 inches. And I shove it in there to hold it open, and I take it out at the following season and push it the other way and wedge it shut. And then I put some insulating tape back over that duct thing and put some insulating tape over my hole that I made in a glove box. So then I have really cold air in the summer and spring, and then decently hot air blowing in the wintertime. So this is why I'm dressed like I'm going off to war in the tundra somewhere.